Thanks for visiting and please subscribe.
The Tiananmen Square protests were student-led demonstrations calling for democracy, free speech, and a free press in China. Pro-democracy protesters, mostly students, initially marched through Beijing to Tiananmen Square following the death of Hu Yaobang, who, a former Communist Party leader, had worked to introduce democratic reform in China. Eventually, thousands of people joined the students in Tiananmen Square, with the protest numbers increasing to tens of thousands. By mid-May, on May 13th, a number of student protesters initiated a hunger strike, which inspired other similar strikes and protests across China. As the movement grew, the Chinese government became increasingly uncomfortable with the protest, particularly as they disrupted a visit by Prime Minister Mikhail Gorbachev of Soviet Union on May 15th. The Chinese government declared martial law on May 20th and 250,000 troops entered Beijing. By the end of May, more than 1 million protesters had gathered in Tiananmen Square. While the initial presence of military failed to crush the protest, the Chinese authorities decided to increase their aggression. At 1 a.m. on June 4th, Chinese soldiers and police stormed Tiananmen Square, firing live rounds into the crowd. Although thousands of protesters simply tried to escape, others fought back, stoning the attacking troops and setting fire to military vehicles. Casualty estimated was hundreds to thousands of protesters were killed in Tiananmen Square massacre, and as many as 10,000 were arrested. Leaders worldwide, including Gorbachev, condemned the military action, and less than a month later, the United States Congress voted to impose economic sanctions against China, citing the human rights violation. So, where does Tankman come into action? The incident took place at the northeast edge of Tiananmen Square along Chang'an Avenue shortly after noon on June 5, 1989, the day after the Chinese government's violent crackdown on the Tiananmen Square protest. Tankman stood in the middle of the wide avenue, directly in the path of a column of approaching Type 59 tanks. Shots were fired and the tank carried on down the road towards the protesters until were blocked by a lone protester. He wore a white shirt and black trousers and he held two shopping bags. As the tank came to a stop, the man gestured towards the tank with one of his bags. In response, the lead tank attempted to drive around the man, but the man reportedly stepped into the path of the tank in a show of non-violent action. After repeatedly attempting to go around rather than crush the man, the lead tank stopped its engine and the armored vehicles behind it also stopped their engine. Having successfully brought the tank to a halt, the man climbed onto the hull of the lead tank and after briefly stopping at the driver's hatch and seemed to have a short conversation with a crew member at the gunner's hatch. After ending the conversation, the man descended from the tank. The tank commander briefly emerged from his hatch and the tanks restarted their engine, ready to continue on. At that point, the man, who was still standing within a meter or two from the side of the lead tank, jumped in front of the vehicle once again and quickly re-established the man-tank standoff. So what happened to that tank man? Little is publicly known of the man's identity or that of the commander of the lead tank. Shortly after the incident, the British tabloid Sunday Express named him Wang Weilin, a 19-year-old student who was later charged with political and attempting to subvert members of People's Liberation Army. However, this claim has been rejected by internal Communist Party of China documents, which reported that they could not find the man. There are several conflicting stories about what happened to him after the demonstration. In a speech to the President's Club in 1999, Bruce, former deputy social assistant to President Richard Nixon, said that he was executed 14 days later. Other sources said he was executed by firing squad a few months after Tiananmen Square protest. Another theory is that he escaped to Taiwan. Still, it is not clear that what happened to that tank man and who he was. But one thing was clear, that tens and thousands of people were killed and Chinese government successfully crushed the protest successfully.
That's it for today's video. Please subscribe our channel for more interesting videos. Bye.